Welcome dear students and learners, this is in our next video on salt analysis series part 3. In this we will discuss cation or basic radicals. So without wasting your time, let's start this series part 3. So the analysis of cation is basically divided into 6 group and plus 1 0 group. So as you can see on the slide, their first group is zero group, having an NOH or a COH2 group reagent, as and basic radical is NH4+, and result is ammonia gas is evolved. Another additional information I can provide you, that when NH2OH react with H2SO4, then you will get an coordination compound complex NH3OH bracket whole power plus, and another one is HSO4-. Its name is hydroxyl ammonium bisulfide. So you must remember this. And when this NH3OH plus is heated or is treated with H+, then it slowly disproportionate into N2 plus NH3 plus H2O. So we are on another one group, the first group, that is its group reagent is dilute HCl, and basic radicals are Ag+, Hg2+, and Pb2+. These its colors are very much important also, as it has been asked in previous year JEE's questions. So one thing I also mentioned, that the color of HgO is red or orange red, but the color of Hg2O is black or a brownish. In silver, you must remember, when phosphate react with dilute HNO3 plus ammonium molybdate, then you get canary yellow PPT. So let's go to the second group. Second A group, basically it is divided into A, second B, on the basis of which is insoluble in yellow ammonium sulfide, as you can see its formula. So in A group, basically there are cations like Hg2+, Pb2+, Bi2+, Cu2+, Cd2+. So it's all sulfide. You also have to remember color also. Basically there is a one difference, that cadmium sulfide is yellow in color, so you must remember this point. In second B group, these are the basic radical which are insoluble in yellow ammonium sulfide. So these are As3+3, Sb+3, Sn+3, and Sn+4. So I have a trick to remember this. So you can remember it color by trick, that these are in the order of As2, S3, Sb2, S3, SnS and SnS2. So these are the color mentioned, so you can remember it by trick YOBY, Y-O-B-Y, and which basic radical is insoluble in YS, you can remember by the trick Aaj Sab Song Sunenge. So you can remember this. I will repeat once again, Aaj Sab Song Sunenge. So another group is group 3, in which there is a group reagent is NH4OH in presence of NH4Cl, and there are the basic radical mentioned, and you can see that it PPT with hydroxide ion. So you must note their color also. So let's go to the group 4. It is H2S in presence of NH4OH plus and NH4Cl. So it is quite different from group 3, by only there is a presence of H2S only, and cations are basically mentioned here are ZnS+2, Mn+2, Cobalt+2, Nickel+2, and their color are also mentioned. So you can see that MnS Manganese sulfide is pink in color, zinc sulfide is white in color. So you must know their color also. So let's go to the group 5. It is having a basic radical Ba plus 2, Sr plus 2, Ca plus 2. All are white in color in carbonate when react with carbonate. And its group reagent is NH4 2 CO3 in presence of NH4 OH. And the last group is group 6. It having Na2HPO4 in presence of NH4 OH, having a basic radical of Mg plus 2. And its PPT is MgNH4PO4. It is white in color. So let's go to the next slide. It is, as you can see, we have to also observe on the basis of color also. So this is in a chart, basically table. So you can see these are the in inference the cations are mentioned, and you can see their observation also. So basically, who gave white observation, white in color observation, they are not at all important at all. So you can see that their color also important one are nickel and cobalt, also Mn plus 2 also. Okay, these are asked in previous year also in JMN and J Advance. So we are on new slide. So before starting our salt analysis, there are some important points regarding the analysis of cations. The first one is, as you can see, that in group first radical there are Ag plus, Hg2 plus, Pb plus 2, as they are treated with dilute HCl form and precipitated as chloride. So as the solubility product of HgCl and these is less than the other chloride of metal ion, so you must note that lead will be present in group first also and group second also. So you have to find the salt, analyze the salt in group first also and group second also, because PbCl2 is slightly soluble in water, so lead is never completely precipitated. So for completing it precipitate, you have to use H2S gas. So when Pb plus react with H2S, you will get PbS in presence of HCl, as it will completely precipitated, but it will be in group second. So Pb plus 2 will present in group first also, group second also. You must note this point. So let's go to the next one. So we are on, it will be on a note on group second radical. So basically it is saying that why we use group second in secondary radical as HCl as a reagent, why we not use H2SO4 or HNO3. So the reason behind is that HCl is the only source of H plus ion. If you use H2SO4, then cation of group 5 will be also precipitated, like BaSO4, SrSO4, CaSO4, etc. But if you use also HNO3, then you will get when HNO3 react with H2S, you will get a sulfur with yellow PPT. So it will cause a confusion with CdS, As2S3, even though they will be absent also. So you will get confused if you use H2SO4 or HNO3. So we use only HCl. So as there is a point also mentioned that solubility product of HGS and all these reagents has in a less than that of a sulfide of other metal ion. Okay, so they will remain in solution, but these group second radical will get precipitated. So we are on new one. You can see that it is on group third radical. So basically it is saying that why we use NH4Cl, why we not use excess of NH4Cl. The reason behind is that when we use excess of NH4Cl, then group 4 radical Mn plus 2 will get precipitated as MnO2.H2O. so basically we not use it. But if we use NH4-2SO4 in place of NH4Cl, then group 5 radical will get precipitated as BaSO4, SrSO4, CaSO4, so it will get also different result as we are expecting. And also if we make the medium acidic, then hydroxide do not precipitated, even though Fe+3 and Cr+3 may be present. So you have to identify the cation also. But if you use acidic medium, then it will not show the presence of Fe+3 and Cr+3. So we will not be helpful by this. So another one is NaOH, sodium hydroxide in place of NH4OH. So in excess of NaOH, we get soluble complexes of Al+3 and Cr+3. So they will not get precipitated. So we will not get any idea that who is present or who is not present. So we are on a new slide. As you can see that it is on a point showing that. So before it is showing that, before we proceed for group 2nd to group 3rd, you have to do an oven process. That is, you have to take the PPT of a salt plus filtrate, then boil it to remove the dissolved H2S so that it not interpret in the group 3rd. So then you have to add concentrated HNO3 and again boil. This is because Fe+2, if it is present, then it will get oxidized to Fe+3. So the reason behind is that if Fe+2 is present, it will interfere in the analysis of group 4 radical. So you must know that this point. And also Ksp of Fe+2 is greater than Fe+3, so it will remain soluble in it. So to go into the next point, first of all I will mention an important note to you. Basically it is a trick. As you are very familiar with the compound like Prussian blue or Turnbull blue, so how you identify them? Any trick you have? So basically I am giving you a trick to identify or differentiate between Prussian blue or Turnbull blue. So formula of Turnbull blue is Fe3FeCN6 whole twice. So basically it is ferro-ferry. So okay. So I am giving you a trick that it is Turnbull blue. So basically the iron present in the coordination, or it is in bracket, it will have show an oxidation state of +3. So you can remember it by Turnbull or Fe3. So basically you can remember it by it. So the another one, Prussian blue, will have a +2 oxidation state of iron in that will present in bracket. So you can remember it by it that Turnbull blue will have the iron oxidation state +3 of an iron present in the coordination or in bracket. And another point I can mention you that Fe2Cl6 is a Lewis acid, so you can remember it. And another point I can mention you that when you heat FeSO4, then you will get Fe2O3 and SO3 and SO2. In previous year papers in 1980s, there was a question asked in a form that the salt is heated and two acidic gases are released. So you must have a hint about it that it is talking about FeSO4. So question can be asked in any format. So now let's start our salt analysis of cation. As we have discussed all our important points and theories, so let's start with our first one, that is group 0 group. It having a radical ammonium ion NH4 plus. So basically, as you can see in the slide, it NH3 has an ammonical smell. So basically, it is treated with then it will be treated with different, like you can see, is MnCl2, CuSO4, HCG2NO3, whole twice. The most important one is the reaction is that when it is treated with HCl, a glass rod dipped in HCl, then it will give now white fumes, NH4Cl, of NH4Cl. So you must know this point. If it is asked in paragraph type format, then you must know that the gas has in a white fume. It is basically talking about NH4Cl. So another one is when it is treated with HG2NO3 whole twice, then it will give in a black PPT. So it, basically the PPT is important, you must note that. And another one is when treated with CuSO4, it will give in a deep blue coordination compound. So you must note this. And also with MnCl2, it will form in a brown color PPT, that is MnOOH whole twice. When it is treated with Mn2+ or H2O2, so you must note that. Another and an important point I am mentioning you that from P block, that when urea is treated with H2O, then you will get an ammonia that is required for fertilizer. But if you also can prepare also by when you treat calcium carbide plus N2 gas, then you will get calcium cyanamide. You can see also its formula, it is containing nitrolium ion. So you must know this formula. I will mention it again in the next video or in next slide. So when this calcium cyanamide is treated with H2O gas, then basically you get ammonia plus calcium carbonate. So by this way you also get calcium carbonate plus ammonia. Ammonia is more important than that, so you can also prepare ammonia by this. And another point I am mentioning, you must note in this your note that critical temperature of ammonia is greater than nitrogen gas. As you can see, critical temperature depend on the structure polarity or dipole moment also. Basically ammonia is in a dipole moment, but N2 gas is neutral or no dipole moment. So we are on new slide. It is showing that when NH4 is treated with different compound, like first one is naphtha reagent, another one is hexanitrito and cobaltate, another one is hexachloroplatinic acid, and so. So you can see that when it is treated with Hg naphtha reagent, you must note is Nestle reagent formula. It can be asked in GE also, and also your board practical exam. So you can see that it will form in a PPT of HgO Hg NH2I. It will basically in a brown PPT. You must note it color also. It can be asked in your practical or in Viva exam. Okay. So another one is when it is treated with this compound CuNO2 whole 6 3-, it will form in a yellow PPT of compound that is shown in the slide. So you can see that another one is hexachloroplatinic acid. It also form yellow PPT of NH4 whole twice PtCl6. So another one is sodium hydrogen tartrate solution. So you can refer organic chemistry to know the structure of hydrogen tartrate. So it will form in a white PPT. You can see that it will form in a white PPT. But if you treat it with 4-nitrobenzene diazonium chloride, it will form in a red coloration of this compound. It is basically an azo dye. Okay, you can also get an orange color by when you treat it with phenol. So you can refer your organic chemistry chapter, so you will get an a better about idea about this in your organic chemistry. here you can get only the reaction, there you can will get a mechanism how it will be performed. As you know that Dysonium is in a good living group, okay, so you can know that this point. So we have completed our first to zero group NH4 plus. So you must you can see in that that basically it form an NH4 ammonium ion. Basically it form in a different PPTs with a different compound. So you can remember their color also. Color are very very much important. So at last I want to ask a new question. So you can give it answer in your comment section, or you can give anyway answer in my next video. So my question is, when you heat PCl3F2, what product will you get? So I am repeating my question. When you heat PCl3F2, what product you will get? So you can comment in the comment section what answer you will get. So I will be waiting. So we are on our end of part 3rd video. So you must revise these reactions or practice these reaction more and more time in on every day, so you have a better grip on these reactions. So we are let's end this video. So at last I will say jab him and be chill, okay? So you will get soon your J main dates or J advanced also. As another point I am mentioning that J advanced IIT Kharagpur has released the information brochure of J advanced. You can refer that also, so you can see that also, but the dates are not mentioned in that information brochure. It will be released soon. So let's end our video.